industrial relations and HR laws are very important for corporate sector. In fact, production, productivity, efficiency, all are related to industrial relations. This presentation will help you in understanding the basis of industrial relations with specific reference to India. Industrial relations are mainly related to workers, employees of an organization, employers, trade unions, employers association, and the government. In case of India, it may be central government or state governments. Industrial relations are regulated in the country through various labor legislations, which are ultimately framed by the central government. Industrial relations mainly arise out of grievances amongst workers, industrial disputes amongst workers, and in fact, the number of disputes determine the level of industrial relations in a country. There are a number of HR laws which govern industrial relations. When we talk about relations of workers with organization, we say that labor relations are related to workplace, which may affect productivity of workers, and we have to concentrate on central or local laws, regulate them, and resolve whatever workplace disputes emerge. When we talk about industrial relations, it is a relationship between workers, employees, employers, trade unions, employers associations, and the government. Workers are those persons who are directly associated with the production process. On the other hand, employees are not directly connected with the production process. They work in offices. However, indirectly, they are connected with the working process and production thereof. Employers, maybe one employer, maybe many employers, so there may be employers association as such. Because when workers get united, employers also get united, and they also work in unity, because workers generally show their strength, and to protect themselves they also go for employers association. The state government is concerned about industrial relations, because industrial relations will affect industry. And the state government goes on a tripartite consultative basis, because the three parties are important: workers, employers, trade unions. It will be a tripartite consultation, because all disputes are to be settled on the basis of that tripartite relations. When we talk about industrial relations, it is employee relations or it is called labor relations. They are all synonyms that way, and in India you find that we can classify the phase of industrial relations into a protective phase, consolidation phase, conflict ridden, interventionist phase, directionless phase, productivity efficiency, quality orientation phase, and the economic growth competitive phase. You know that up to 1990, the industrial relations were traditional. Traditional in the sense that we were working in a regulated economy. We had adopted Russian model, and there were public sector, private sector. In public sector, workers enjoyed a superior position. And in fact, there was not more of economic reforms. Of course, so far as labor reforms are concerned, still they have not been carried out, despite the fact that we have already introduced first generation economic reforms and second generation economic reforms also. However, after 1991, we have started the process of globalization, and with globalization, we have started economic growth and a competitive phase, in the sense that now we have resorted to market economy. And with market economy, actually, we have given more freedom to employers. And that is why now employers are employing workers on the basis of contract. Or they get workers through contractors. And they do not like to have a permanent labor force, because the moment you make workers permanent, their efficiency is not retained in the same manner as they started. That is the problem, and that is why now state governments, central government, now they wish to make HR laws more employer friendly, so that employers are comfortable, they can increase efficiency, enhance quality of product, and they go for better workforce, so that they can compete in the global markets. That is most essential for maintaining quality of global standards. When we talk about industrial relations, actually we have a democratic setup, and therefore we have to depend on bargaining power, or in other words, we try to settle industrial disputes on the basis of collective bargaining or mutual negotiations or mediation. At this stage, one should know that industrial relations are governed by the Industrial Disputes Act. We have a machinery for the settlement of industrial disputes, and the government machinery includes conciliation. Conciliation is a government machinery. So, whenever there is a dispute, you have to report to the conciliation officer. Or you go for mediation on a private basis, because through mediation you can persuade both the parties to settle the industrial disputes. Otherwise, matter is referred to arbitration. There may be an arbitration board which will look into all the demands of workers. Cement industry is a good example where almost all industrial disputes are settled through an arbitration board, where that arbitration board will have sittings with workers, trade unions. It will have sitting with cement industry at various places and try to resolve all demands of workers on the basis of mutual discussions, and they give an arbitration clause. This is how industrial relations in cement industry in India are better as compared to other industries. When we talk about industrial relations, which may be traditional, and in modern times we talk about employee relations, where we include workers and employees both. Now here, we may have labor relations, or we call industrial relations. They have a traditional dimension, where employee relations, where we have modern values which we undertake. In fact, we have a contract, a psychological contract with workers, and we have to maintain good relations. Traditionally, we were more interested in compliance of labor laws. We were more concerned about norms, customs, practices. There was a low trust. Workers did not have trust in the employers, and there was less emphasis on workers. Now we have shifted to commitment. We want commitment from employees, workers, so that they have total dedication to production, productivity, efficiency. We give more emphasis on values. We have a corporate vision in addition to the vision, and everyone strives to achieve that mission. We go on the basis of high trust. Individually, we go for confidence in each other and work in a cohesive manner. And we emphasize on teamwork, of course, with greater autonomy, with self-discipline. There is no discipline on the basis of terror, but self-control, that you impose discipline on yourself. Now when we want to study industrial relations, the first question before us is, what is the relevance of industrial relations? You know that industrial relations are related to a relationship between workers, employees, employers, trade unions. Now all these relations will ultimately affect production. If there is dispute, we start with a grievance, where we may have dissatisfaction amongst the workers. Grievance is the first stage where we notice a dissatisfaction amongst workers on certain issues. Grievance should be addressed initially. The moment it crops up, HR manager must try to redress the grievance then and there. But if HR department fails to look into the matter, then a grievance turns into an industrial dispute. Now, if industrial dispute is at the plant level, it is okay. We try to resolve it, but it spreads to other industries also. At the industry level, then the settlement of industrial disputes will be difficult. In fact, we say that you must have harmonious industrial relations. If you have harmonious industrial relations, then it will lead to prosperity in the country. In most of the Western countries, they have harmonious labor management relations. They go on the basis of better negotiations with each other. They have good relationship with union employees, and therefore they have better industrial relations. That will in fact affect the entire industry. If industrial disputes are not settled in a proper manner, then it becomes a challenge for the management. Workers are compelled to unionize and they may be militant and they may try to compel employers to resolve those industrial disputes. Whenever there is unionization, then outside players will join, and when they join, then the scene is not conducive to the industry. In fact, that organized labor will be a challenge for the management. And when we talk about unionized work, then it will have an impact on organization's cost structure. And naturally, payroll expenses will increase, because from time to time they will have more demands, and more demands will lead to more problems. Now, when we have better industrial relations, then it will increase profitability in an organization. Profitability has a direct correlation with the productivity, and because of higher productivity and profitability, there will be more entry of new firms, which will generate more employment. More employment means more incomes of people, and if there are more incomes, it leads to more expenditure. Indirectly, it motivates consumers to buy more goods from other industries. Hence, demand for goods in other industry will increase, and that will again increase the profitability of those companies. Indirectly, everywhere there will be employment, full employment, and with more incomes, the standard of living will rise. That is why we must have harmonious labor management relations. But India is a poor country. In India, employers are now progressing. Still, at micro level, if we look at small scale industry, micro industries, medium scale industries, still workers are exploited, and for protecting those workers from exploitation, a number of acts have been implemented, and the state government is responsible for regulating all these acts. We have a number of labor legislation, say Minimum Wages Act, Payment of Wages Act, Equal Remuneration Act, Factories Act, Industrial Disputes Act, Employee State Insurance Act relating to Social Security, Industrial Employment Standing Orders, where we maintain a continuity in working. We have, say, Payment of Bonus Act, Payment of Gratuity Act. After retirement, naturally one has to pay gratuity, that is a measure of Social Security, Trade Union Act, Workplace Compensation Act, which is related to total disablement, partial disablement, and we give compensation to workers who meet with an accident. But it must be noted that all these acts have been inherited from British India, and these acts have not been revised in a proper manner. That is what I said initially, that labor sector reforms are yet to be introduced in the country. And unless all these old acts are implemented, say this is Act of 1923, Act of 1926, Trade Union Act is obsolete. Obsolete in the sense that it has no provision for election of a representative trade union. Then what is the advantage of having a Trade Union Act which cannot give you one representative trade union to participate in dispute settlement machinery or negotiations or collective bargaining? Should we carry on with these acts, or we should make changes, drastic changes? Say when we look at these acts, say when we talk about Minimum Wages Act, Factories Act, 48, so old enough, it needs revision. Industrial Disputes Act, since independence, we are going with this act, and there are no changes in the machinery given in the Industrial Disputes Act. ESIA, same 1940, Provident Funds Act, 1952. Is it not possible that we make drastic changes in all these acts so that we go for better industrial relations? Say Trade Unions Act, there is no method for recognition. Whereas you find that in USA there is recognition of a trade union. In India, there is no mandate by the law to recognize a particular trade union. And in fact, if trade unions are not recognized, the entire negotiation process will come to a grinding halt, and therefore we have to revise the Trade Unions Act so that disputes are settled in a proper way, and accordingly we may have better industrial relations. Now, when we talk about Trade Unions Act, we may have a registered trade union, but there is no recognized trade union. In other countries, we establish a trade the recognition, and for years to come, for that period, that will be a representative trade union. When we talk about labor legislations under Factories Act or other acts, we go for labor welfare measures under Industrial Disputes Act. We talk about different committees which may negotiate the dispute, which may be required for preserving amity and cordial relations. But works committees in India have miserably failed. There is no role given for works committees. Now, ultimately, what happens? If we do not have better industrial relations, that means that there will be industrial disputes. If there are industrial disputes, there will be strikes. Unions will organize. There will be unionization. And to protect themselves, unions will try to strengthen so that they can have a better collective bargaining process. In fact, militancy of workers started with Dhera, and till now we have militancy. The latest example is of Maruti Suzuki Limited at Manesar plant, where HR managers were even got hurt by physical assault, and that plant remained closed. And then government intervened, and the government said, okay, we must start the industry again. Had the government checked indiscipline among workers, well, industrial relations would have been better. Therefore, a better process of collective bargaining must be introduced. At workplace, we must have continuous bargaining where we negotiate terms of employment and try to resolve the industrial disputes. That is a table discussion. We must have a table discussion and try to settle each and every point that will maintain a better level of industrial relations. The collective bargaining has a very wider scope, and in Western countries, collective bargaining has brought success in maintaining better industrial relations. You find that almost all matters may be discussed through collective bargaining. It may be wage fixation, increments, bonus payments, hours of work, overtime work, conditions of work, safety, welfare, health care, grievance procedure, labor productivity, how to increase it, and how to reward them on the basis of increased labor productivity. And participation of workers. Say in India, we have failed to introduce workers' participation in management. Of course, in public sector, say public sector banks, they have started appointing a director from employees' union. That sort of workers' participation is possible. But the scheme of workers' participation in India has not been very successful because of less progressive nature of employers who do not want to give any such facility to workers. In fact, ultimately, only through negotiations, employers, employees, unions, they can negotiate the benefits, and on that basis, you can have a better industrial relations. Now if workers come for collective bargaining, management will also be benefited, because if there is industrial peace, there will be no hindrance to the work. If there is no work stoppage, well, there will be no loss to the nation, because it is national loss. If there is any strike, if work stoppage comes, well, that is a loss to the entire nation. And therefore, we have to see that workers, unions, management, they all negotiate and settle all such industrial disputes. Now the process of collective bargaining is very important, where we must have negotiations. Now trade unions representatives are selected, and after negotiations we come to collective agreement. If we have better collective agreement, that will be religiously implemented, and that collective bargaining may be at enterprise level, at industry or sectoral bargaining we may go for, or the entire economy may have collective bargaining to settle such industrial disputes. Now in bargaining, we set up a committee where we have representatives from management, that is management bargaining team, where we have an advocate, human resource representatives, and employers representative. Union bargaining, we may have local union. Of course, unions in India are affiliated to political parties. Say ITAR has affiliation with Congress. Similarly, ITAR has affiliation with Communist Party. Therefore, those unions may select their bargaining team, and accordingly they may have settlement. When we go for collective bargaining, we have to follow a particular step, that we will discuss all those disputed matters, and the company may get data about the benefits, leave, discipline matters, dismissals, grievance, overtime, what are the labor practices in other companies, because there must be parity in different industries. Workers should be paid at par with other industries. And what are the labor legislations which are involved in settlement of industrial disputes, that also we should try to set up. So ultimately we go for negotiation process. Members of the bargaining teams will consult each other, they will have negotiations, they will discuss major issues, and on the basis of those major issues, then they will try to settle the industrial dispute. Now when we talk about collective bargaining process, well, we must have proper communication so that there is no communication gap, and then we arrive at collective bargaining. This should be put up in writing, that must be acceptable by all the parties, and then copies of that agreement should be widely distributed, so everyone knows the terms and conditions of the collective bargaining agreement. Another situation where there is a failure to reach agreement, when say unions, employees, workers, they are unable to arrive at a settlement, there may be strike, there may be unfair labor practices, there may be strikes at a wider level. Now that will injure the state of industrial relations. In conclusion, we can say that industrial relations purely depend on parties to industrial relations. All these parties may be unions, employers, employers association, workers, employees, and the government. Well, government can call representatives of employers, of workers, and they government machinery may persuade them to settle industrial dispute. If there is proper government intervention, well, industrial disputes can be settled, and if we have proper grievance machinery, proper machinery for settlement of industrial disputes under revised Industrial Disputes Act, well, we may have harmonious industrial relations which will ultimately lead to prosperity in the country. This is how under HR we try to emphasize that HR people, HR executives must strive to maintain good industrial relations. In conclusion, we can say that unions must develop partnership with employers, and there should be win-win outcomes in collective bargaining. At the same time, workers must enhance their performance so that there is effectiveness, more efficiency. And in future also, they must strive to work hard with an agenda to work more and more. If you look at countries like Japan, Germany, they have extensive unionization. However, they produce highest quality, and they have technologically advanced products. Is it not possible in our country also, where workers should be educated? And if employees, workers, union representatives all work in a cohesive manner, well, their productivity will increase. Now, of course, we may have different case studies. Number of case studies are given, where you find in America, United Airlines, this is the world's largest airline, has given employee stock ownership, ESOP, where they give shares, allot shares to workers, and they work as if they are representative of the company, and that is why they increase efficiency and profitability of the company. There may be number of such case studies, say strikes of Jet Airways, where number of pilots went on strike. However, there was intervention by the High Court, and with that intervention, actually they had to come to a settlement. Ultimately, there is a golden rule that prevention is better than cure. If you can prevent disputes,